Hey, Father, we thank you tonight. We give you praise. We present ourselves before you. Soak ourselves into the blood. Let the blood come and take actual control tonight. Come and take actual control, God. Let your hand be strong upon each and everyone that watch me live from all the multimedia system. Tonight is a night that you are coming to receive the word of God. Father, take me aside and come and speak to your children. Let your protection be on them. Let your light shine upon them. Tonight is a night of freedom. Father, Holy Ghost, angels, I invite you to come and take actual control. Take actual control. Set your children free and free forever. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Hey. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I thank everybody that tonight were here with me. Tonight, God is going to touch somebody tonight. It doesn't matter about whatever you are going through. It doesn't matter about whatever the enemy has done concerning your life. God is here tonight to touch you. Prepare your heart and receive the word of God. I thank everybody that are watching me live from Facebook and YouTube, all the multimedia system that you are watching me live. Thank you. You are welcome to the program tonight. This is your Reverend Ebenezer Sacharias Protocol. I thank you that tonight you are here with me. I thank you that you will always be prompt and watch me live. Wherever you are, when you are watching me live, may the good God continue to protect you and bless you as well. Tonight I have a new good news for you. Tonight I have yet to just entertain you before the word of God comes. I thank you that you are watching me live from Hope for Life Radio. You can also go to www.hopeforlife.com. www.hopeforlife.com and watch me live. You can also go to Google Plus. If you have a Google Plus, you can also go to Google Plus, or you can go to Instagram, go to Skype, or tune in. You can watch me live and join me into the studio. You can also go to www.mordinghana.com. www.mordinghana.com. You can also watch me live. Wherever you are watching me live from Facebook, YouTube, all the multimedia system, you are welcome to the program tonight. This is your Reverend Ebenezer Sacharias Protocol. You are welcome. Maybe I'll show me via Facebook and YouTube. Maybe I'm more about the Uber to my dear Weso. I hope for life for Radio Namuti Yankai. I will soon for Makua Ebenezer Sacharias Protocol. And then you may more ask me to Yamia Sambeba Mio as a bombaya. And then you remember how saying you over prepare what come as soon as you met in Sabaka and then you lay. I'm found in your offer and found near TTV at also. Or how be our form will be our how not to change. The prayer you and your men who are being a man who are prepared what come and you go on between your touch. I am here to entertain you before the word of God comes. Just prepare your heart. It's your Reverend again. I am here to entertain you before the word of God comes. All my friends that are watching me live from Facebook and YouTube, please share the video. If you are watching me from Facebook, please share. Make sure that you share the video. Call somebody that Reverend is here. Reverend is here again. I am here to give you the word of God. I am here to protect you. I am here to pray that God's hand will be strong upon your life. I am here to ask God that may the good God continue to protect you and bless you. It doesn't matter about whatever you are going through tonight. It doesn't matter about whatever the enemy has done concerning your life. One thing that I know that God is here tonight to touch you. May the This is Hope for Life Radio. Baby, I will be an Obata Minka Africa, baby. Baby, I will Israel, so Obata Minka. Baby, I will show you Japan, South Korea, Thailand, Cambodia, Vietnam. Oh, you are all welcome to the program tonight. Hey! The great family, Samuma Minfa Ento or Manfoina, so members be our the great family. Tande Ebe, Cassia Ebe, Yombabe meeting Cassia, Ewo or more lioness, so in Tianumre, the founder of the great family, Cecilia Boatin, say. Mipantumanim says Sunday, non song, Yababe ye meeting Cassia no biara, Ushemibio biara, Utimibiano, Bomadias of a general no ababe meeting, Wati. The meeting the Inkika Shababa. A ye great family, ye can great family, a cocobataya, the ma eshanias, a cocobataya, the main ashanas, and soon ta and canema, a cocobataya bono mahumai, a cocobataya odidi omanema. Inti great family abusi akasiye obiara a uni kuo bia wo jwen no mepresse bomadi aso be fresse no ma wei no ba be jwen se abusi akasi because e yabusi a ye kasi wo be mo aho beto aho kire bia wo da osu bia omo boa boa nkrofo yare na ofem oha bi na da osu a omo wasofo omo onkunumdie omo doctors ne ade ina wo a on betumi aboa wo ananyum re sa otemi nka na ohwe mi a A great family, a Busiana Mimbo de Uri. Opens up a genuine man, opens up a genuine dia, and it's no mate away. No money of 571-490-1230. Missy no man's subio 571-490-1230. Any power down on the Sicilia Boating. Bomadi asa obe freno. No aga chense, mami sisi, mibese mabe jeni mukono. Bra, ne kwa oho mao. Nkunumdiye oho mao. Great family. Akuko bata yo ni mne yam makom. Enye kuo biya na benyane sa. E kuo wedye misi, kuku dam fo wum. Empai botu ya. Asa fo wum. Doctors fo wum, lawyers fo wum. Obiye bi wum. Nurses home, doctors home. In the idea, no how. But what they are so bad, join one more. Fratano Mana Media to Jai 571-490-1230. But what they are so bad, Francis Gilly Abotting. Now catch us a mammy, Sissy. Also for say, I'm a journey cool. Obed Joe. Now I have a fair fit. So, what control us only if only who are control us only Bribia yet, ya, mammy or Timmy. Bomodia so don't hobe she could be mate. Obi ni mochna. Ochna be ritua. E kue be mate na wa bao ho. Aba be buau. E kebia be mubi e kue ne befa. Inti mi wa hapo de uro se bomodia so be jani great family e wusi yin. Ne be buau. E be buau. Uwo ahunim diye bi anaso uwo bribi ape se. O friend no manan kwa bomodia so be friend reverend. Frami, now Frami, I remember Auntie Sisi asked what he now went to me about the journey. Yeah, quiet. Tonight, I thank you that you are watching me live from Facebook and YouTube, all the multimedia system. The great family is announced that Sunday, 7 o'clock p.m., they are going to do their official meeting. They are going to do an official meeting. So anybody that you are part of them, make sure that Sunday, 7 p.m., you'll be prompt into the prayer line so that they can discuss about the great family. the meeting that they are going to have into their this occasion. It's a great family. There is a very dynamic organization. Dynamic that the pastors and lawyers and the doctors are included. Sister, brother, that you are watching me live. Maybe you don't have any organization to join, but I am here to introduce this great family to you. Make sure that you join them. Make sure that you call the lady so that the lady will just accept you. If you are calling and you cannot get them, just call Reverend. I am here to connect you. The number is 571-490-1230. 571-490-1230. Make sure that you call Cecilia Boateng. Cecilia Boateng, call and join this organization. It's very powerful. God bless you that you are watching me live. Tonight, I'm requesting this song to my own son. My son, today is your birthday. Happy birthday, my son. May the good God continue to bless you. May the good God continue to raise you up. May the good God continue to bless you until you bless. God, I pray for my son. Let your hand be strong upon him. I ask the wisdom that you give it to Solomon. I ask that wisdom for him. Everywhere that he stands, Father, raise him. Take him to the level that you, God, want to take him. Today is his birthday, and I know that you, God, has actually control. Junior, wherever you are, this is your father. I greet you and a happy, happy, happy birthday. I thank you that you are watching me live. All people that are watching me live, make sure that you share the page. You call somebody that Reverend is here tonight. Maybe I'll show me if you have a body as a page, you know, best share why. For being a catcher and Reverend about your same paper. Hey, young man. Everybody of God that you are watching me live, you are welcome to the program tonight. I am here to just entertain you before the word of God comes. Yes, 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 yes thank everybody that were here with me, all my friends that were watching me live from Germany. You are welcome to the program. God's son in Yamiba, Mama, praise and grace to Tua. Oh! Yes, you're better than Yasua, baby. Baby, I'll show you more cover. I am Reverend and I am Reverend Wabawi. Meeting Yamia seven ever. Asamayam. Maturity said, rejoice in the Lord. Rejoice in the Lord. Mawani, you on Yamimu, what is it? Obi, I'll show you Yamuani, you on Yamimu. That you need to focus on God. The only thing that you need to believe on Him, just put your hope and your trust on Him. When you believe on Him, God is going to give you that anointing. You need a breakthrough in your life. You need a protection in your life. Only God who can give it to you. No man can give it to you. So prepare your heart so that God can release that anointing upon your life. I am here to pray for you. I am here to protect you as well. I am asking God to give you the anointing of Him. I thank you that you are watching me live on Facebook and YouTube and the multimedia system that you are watching me. You are welcome to the program. Make sure that you share the video this morning. Make sure that you share the video this afternoon. Make sure that you share the video tonight. Wherever you are watching me live, you are welcome to the program. This is your Reverend. I am here to entertain you before the word of God comes. The title of the message is to rejoice in the Lord. I know that you are watching me live from Facebook and YouTube. Adwa, wherever you are, I salute you. Anita Banya, you are also in Chicago. I know that you are watching me. Adams and your wife. Boss Adams, I salute you. You and your wife, this song goes to you as well. Angelina, Angie, wherever you are, you and mommy, this song goes to you. The great family, the founder of the great family, Cecilia Barton, this song goes to you as well. Cecilia Barton, maybe I will be a new way come out when we're busy. Naomi Nyako, you are in Koforudia, Kokron to me hospital. Azafu Mami Naomi, baby, I will be having more Gabado Bajumadiso. Cindy Nyako, you are also part of them. You are also working in Koforudia, Kokron to me hospital. I know that you are watching me live. I know that Naomi Nyako, you are watching me live from Koforudia, Kokran to me, and Cindy as well. You're also watching me live. Naomi Nyako, Osafumami. So wherever you are listening to me, you are welcome to the program tonight. I know that you are in the hospital right now. This song also go to my mother, Didi Dufour, whatever you are, this song go to you. Aminata, I know that you are watching me live. Aminata, this song go to you as well. And I'm on Vera, you also in Canada. Need a day, you also in Canada, this song go to you as well. In Maryland, Kinsaki, also watching me in Africa. You are welcome. Abaya Ajewa, Mami Abaya Ajewa, I know that you are watching me live. You are welcome. Baba Edward, I know that you are watching me live from Maryland. Baba Edward, my sister. Whatever you are welcome to the program tonight. This is your brother. You are welcome to the program tonight. Oh, bye, Ajewa. This song go to you and brother Edward, who are also in Maryland. This song go to you and Josephine, Joe, you are working in Nova Hospital. This song goes to you. And Joyce Bambo. Joyce Bambo, wherever you are, this song also goes to you. Grace Salu, I know that you are watching me live from Ohio. Sister Mary, Sister Tiwa, and Phyllis Dubia in New York. Very soon I'm going to enter into the Bible. I ain't Jakra, you be with Bible, you only have to get your thank you that you are here with me. All the members that are watching me live, you are welcome to the program. I salute every military personnel, every military person in the world that you are devoting your time, your life for your country. You are fighting for your country. You are welcome to the program tonight. Wherever you are, I salute you, and may God continue to protect you and guide you. You're going out and you're coming home to be blessed. Every military person that you are wearing uniform into the world. This song specially go to German people. Oh, God send Yamiba, Mama Praise and Grace Tutua. This is the song that you requested. This song go to you as well. May the good God continue to guide you. Hey! This song also goes to Cecilia Boating. Mommy, Cici, baby, I'll tell you, Cecilia Boating. And you will come out with a bush. Thank you, Lord. Hey, yeah, yeah, hey, ah. Very soon the word of God will be coming. Just prepare your heart and receive the word of God is coming. Every man of God that you are here watching me live, you are welcome to the program tonight. Bishop Perry, Bishop Luke Perry, Prophet Obed, Senior Major Fajasia, Frank, Prophet Frank in Kaswa, Prophet Frank in Kumase, Bishop Onisia Nanasei. You are welcome to the program tonight that you are watching me live. I salute each and everyone. I salute your anointing as well. Come that you need to bring the word of God. I thank each and everyone that you are watching me. God bless you that you are here with me. Make sure that you share the page wherever you are listening to my voice. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I have a message tonight for you. The title of the message is Rejoice in the Lord. Mawalini awe uradimu. Rejoice in the Lord. Every Christian that will watch me, without rejoicing in the Lord, you cannot glorify. Sometimes you go through pains. Sometimes you go through troubles and trials. Sometimes you go through all kinds of things. But all things, we need to give thanks to God. You need to rejoice in the Lord. God is the God that is always protecting you. He's a God that always makes your foot. He's a God that always protecting you going out and you're coming home. No matter how, what kind of sickness that you are going through, no matter how, what kind of problem that you are going through, sister, brother, that you are listening to me tonight, I am here to assure you, just rejoice in the Lord always. The mistake that you have done is gone. That mistake will never come back again. The problem that you are facing will go. It will never come back again. Because God is there always to protect you. God is there always to take you out and brought you home. Our God is the Alpha and the Omega, beginning and the end. Tonight, I am here to share this word with you. Tonight, the title of the message is Rejoice in the Lord. I want to read Philippians chapter 4, verse 4 coming down. It says, Rejoice in the Lord always. Always rejoice in the Lord. Don't think that, if God bless me before, I'll be happy about God. Don't say, because except God have done something for me, because I'll go to my knees and say, God, I thank you. Yesterday you slept. And even at all, you don't know the time that you slept. And you don't know the time that you wake up. It's by his grace that's what tonight, me and you, we are alive. So everything that you are going through, just rejoice in the Lord. Whether good or whether bad, just accept it. Embrace every challenge in your life. Because the Bible says, I will say it again. Rejoice, let the gentle be advanced to all. The Lord is near. Do not exult about anything. But it's every situation, prayer and petition. With thanksgiving, present your request to him. And God, and the Lord peace of God, which transform all understand, will guide you, your heart and your mind in Jesus Christ. Philippians chapter 4, verse 4 to 7. God shall rejoice on him. No matter how, whatever situation that you are going through. Rejoice in the Lord all the time. Do not be afraid at anything. Don't worry about everything that you are going through. Don't worry about things that you cannot see and fighting against your life. Don't worry about circumstances that you see around. Don't worry about your situation that today you are in. Maybe because of the coronavirus, there is no work for you. You are crying that, oh God, how can I pay my bills? How can I eat? How can my children eat? God is going to provide. God is going to open a door where there is no door. that you are serving that God is a miracle God. Every situation that you are going through, just go to your knees and pray to Him. Go to your knees and pray. Go to your knees and request. Make sure that everything that you go through, just present to God. Sometimes somebody say, "Oh, man of God, I pray for so long. I don't have no answer." You did not request or you did not present your case to God. You are sick. All right. But you haven't presented your sickness to God for Him to heal you. Your situation is bad. It's all right. Everybody knows. But you haven't presented it to God. Your marriage is sukumsa. Something that you yourself, you're not happy about your marriage. But you haven't presented it to God. The business that has collapsed, we haven't presented that business to God. The baby that you need a child, but up to now, we haven't presented that child or you haven't presented your prayer to Him. Because the Bible said, verses, do not hesitate about anything, but in every situation, be prayer and petition. With thanksgiving, present your request to God. Present your request to Him. Whatever you are going through, just present to God. Without present to God, God would never do anything. It's like you are going to hospital. And if you go to hospital and you didn't tell the doctor the reason why that you came to the hospital, the doctor cannot do anything for you. The doctor cannot do nothing for you. But tonight I am here to tell you that every situation that you are going through, just present it to God. Be happy. Rejoice in the Lord. Rejoice in the Lord. Because it's a God that always is there for us. That God that is there yesterday, the same God is there today. Present your case to Him. Without present your case to God, God will never do anything for you. Because the Bible said, every situation that you are in, be a prayerful and petition. And with thanksgiving, and present to God. Some of the Christians, before they say, "God, I thank you," that means they are praying to God that, "God, give me money." If God did not give them money, they cannot say, "God, I thank you for the day." But you don't know that the time that you slept, the enemy is fighting against your life. You don't know that the time that you are in the bed, enemy is fighting to kill you, that you don't want you to wake up. But God is protecting you. The same God is guiding you. But you refuse to say, "God, I thank you that today I'm alive." You are forgetting that you need to say, "God, I thank you for everything that I went through." You are forgetting that you need to say, "Oh God, I thank you that you, God, has taken me out and brought me home safe." Sometimes Christians, before a Christian will thank God, that means something that he has happened to him or her. But I am here to tell you that every little thing that you go through, when you wake up in the morning, the first thing that you need to give thanks to God. When you wake up in the morning, just go to your knees and go and say, "God, I thank you for my life and for my family." Because some people could not even wake up. Some people could not even see the sky. But you and me, if you can see the sky, we can wake up. Then God has a purpose for us. I don't know whatever you are going through. Maybe because of the secret that you are going through. So you think that maybe God cannot do nothing for you. Maybe because of the situation that you are in today, you think that maybe God cannot change the wind. But I am here to tell you that the wind can change. Because your life is in the hands of God. So far as your life is in the hands of God, God can change the wind for you. But the only thing that you need is just prepare yourself. The only thing that you need is focus your mind and put your hope on Him. The only thing that you need is just embrace God. Whatever you are doing, God first before yourself. And everything that you do, let God lead before you follow. Don't go before God. Because it's a God that always protecting you. It's a God that always guiding you. So far as it's guiding you, God has a purpose for your life. Otherwise, like you allow the devil or the witchcraft or demon to torment your life. He said, oh, Pastor, oh, you see the sickness that I'm going through. If God is there, yes. If God is there still, you go through that sickness. Why? Because God is preparing you. Because God is preparing you. Without God preparing you, you cannot get to your destination. Sometimes your destination is going on the road into your destination. There is a darkness. So God needs to prepare you here so that if you get to your darkness, you can go through. I am here to tell you tonight. What are you going through that God cannot bear? What are you going through that God cannot do it? Maybe you think that maybe your problem is bigger than God. That's why your problem cannot solve. But tonight I am here to talk to you, madam. I am here to talk to a gentleman that you are hearing me. You are watching me from the Facebook. I want you to share the page. I am here to just talk to you tonight that whatever situation that you are going through, present it to God. Whatever disappointment and delay that in your life, present everything to Him. Let God take actual control in your life. You need God in your life. You need God in your situation. You need God in your marriage. You need God in your business. You need God in your job. Without God, what can you do? Sometimes Christians, we're forgetting sometimes what God has done for us. Sometimes whatever we need, we are always praying that God, this is what we need. God knows that you need this, but in appropriate time, God will never give it to you. Without God preparing you, God will never give whatever you need to you. Because God needs to prepare you for you to become strong before He can release the blessing upon your life. Before He can open that door for you. Before He can give you the womb for you to give birth. Before your business can rise up again. When you present to Him God, God will take actual control. Because God is Alpha and the Omega, beginning and the end. Nobody can compare Himself unto Him. He's a God that always do a miracle. He's a God that always protect. He's a God that always do everything for us. So let us make sure that every situation that we are in or we are going through, God is there to solve it for us. No matter how, whatever you see yourself. Yesterday, that's what I said. I said, see yourself the way God sees you. Don't see yourself that maybe you cannot make it in life. Tonight, the Bible said, rejoice in the Lord all the time. No matter how, whether you have, whether you don't have, rejoice in the Lord. No matter how the situation that you are going through, rejoice in the Lord. No matter how that your marriage has been something that you think that you cannot solve, rejoice in the Lord. Your finance has been broken. Your finance is very poor. Rejoice in the Lord. Just go to your knees and say, God, I thank you that I have this money in the account. Mention that amount. And you know definitely that you don't have anything. At the moment when he said it, God is a miracle God that will make that thing to happen live. God have done it for several people. This is your moment and this is your time. I don't know why you are going through all this. I don't know why you are crying all this. I don't know why you think that maybe God is not exist. I don't know why that you claim that maybe God cannot help you. God is here to help you. God is here to open that door for you. God is here to prepare you to for the next generation. Without God prepare you, you cannot be matured. You're not matured in Christianity. You are not matured in Christianity. Because if you are matured in Christianity, every circumstance that you're going through, you give thanks to God. No matter how. No matter how. Whatever you go through, the first thing that you need to give thanks to Him. If you are faithful God, if you are faithful Christian, or if you are matured Christian, you know what to do. But sometimes, because of you are not matured, every situation that come on in your way, then you are shaking. You don't know what to do. But you don't know that when every situation comes, God is preparing you to another realms. God is preparing you for your blessing. God is preparing you for another realms. God is preparing you for the door that had been shut. That's what God is preparing you for. God wants you to be strong. God wants you to know that He's the only one that He can help you. Don't put your hope and your trust on someone. That person cannot help you. Christians, that is our mistakes. We are always putting into someone. We are always thinking that, oh, somebody will help me. So when the time comes and that person did not help us, then it turned to a problem for us. So, sister, brother, that you are here tonight, who are watching me live, why you don't present your case to God? Because Philippians chapter 4, verse 6 coming down, is saying, it's saying, in everything, God said, in everything, every situation, everything that you are going through, everything, just present it to Him. Present to Him. That is what you need. You need to present your case to Him. Because that God can do it for you. That God can protect you. That God can protect your children. That God can open that door that has been shut for so long. That God is going to open that door for you, a job door that you are looking for. But you don't present to Him. If you don't present to Him, how can God open that door for you? Somebody say, oh, Pastor, oh, but I'm a Christian. Yes, it's true, you are a Christian. But the Bible said, everything that you are going to present it to Him, God. Without present to God, God will never do anything for you. It doesn't matter that you are a Christian. Maybe your Christianity are not valid. Maybe you don't have faith in God. Maybe your faith, you are always stumble. So I think that, I don't know whether God can do it or whether God cannot do it. That is your mind. How can God help you? How can God protect you? Because you are doubting. A doubting spirit You are thinking that you don't know whether God can help you or not. That is your mind. Because Bible said in Isaiah 55:8, it said, your ways are not God's ways and your thoughts are not God's thoughts. So you can think about that, but that is not how God thinks. That is not how God sees you. You see your way, that maybe God cannot help you, but that is not how God sees you. You see that maybe at the time that in your age, you think that maybe you cannot give birth. That is your mind, not God's mind. That is your thinking. You are thinking that you don't think that you can give birth again. But sister, brother, that you are listening to me, I am here to tell you that age is just a number. Age is just a number. You can be 100 years, but still God can open that door for you to get child. Sarah is 80 years, but still God opened a door for him, for her. I don't know whatever you are going through. I don't know how long that your problem that you are crying for has been. I don't know how long that you are fighting about this marriage up to today. I don't know how long that they have fired you and you are home up to today. I don't know whether 1 year or 2 years, 3 years, I don't know. But God said, present your case to him. No matter how that they have fired you from your job, that you don't have a work. When you present to him, God will make a way where there is no way. The same God that takes you from the wilderness, the same God is here. And the same God will make sure that it will take you to your destination. So why are you don't want to present your case and everything to him? Present it to him. Tell him that God, this is the situation that I'm going through. And I know that you, God, you can open a door for me. And surely, God is going to open that door for you. Upon everything that you are going through. Maybe your children, the way Amanda, you think that your children will be, maybe after today, your children cannot be. Why you don't present your children to him? Maybe you are thinking that, this marriage, I should stay on or I should move. Why you don't present this marriage to God? Bible said every situation that you are in, present it to him. Without present your case to him, God, how can God help you? How can God open the door for you? Moment when you present it to him, God is going to prepare you and open that door for you. You need God to touch your life, but you don't want to open your heart for God to come in. You need God to deliver you, but you don't want to open your heart for you to receive the word of God. Without opening your heart, how can God? I don't know whatever you are going through, sister. Maybe your finance, you are broken. You broke that, even at all what you eat is a problem. But you are forgetting that it's God who share money. You are forgetting that your father that you are, your father that will give you birth is rich. It's God. He have everything. So why you don't present your case to him? Why you don't tell your father whatever you are going through? Why are you hiding from your father? Because when you tell your father know how he can manage and take you out from that situation. Why are you crying? You cry that maybe you cannot make it in life. Oh, pastor, you don't know the failure that has failed. Failure is not your portion. Every failure is just a preparation. When you fail, it doesn't mean that you cannot make it. When you try several times that it doesn't work, it doesn't mean that you cannot make it. I don't know whatever you are going through. But I am here to tell you that everything that you are going through, God is here to make it. That God is here tonight to protect you. That God is here tonight to open a door for you. That God is here tonight for everything that has been shut. God is here to open that door. Ewurade wa hasa pumbi emu atu bi obebui. Sa oma ho kan na ewurade bemu a ewurade ade bi asai wa brabom no ewurade beye. A lot of things has been spoiled in your life, and right now you are thinking, how can you solve it? There is nothing that you can do to solve it. Only God who can solve it for you. Only God who can help you. Maybe you are listening to me and you are going through all kind of things that you even thought you cannot remember, you cannot bear. You think that, oh, I am enough is enough, because right now I don't know what I can do. Because it's overwhelming. Oh God, come to my aid. Yes, present it to him. And moment when you present it to him, God will come into your aid. And then I'll come and grab into me. Oh, how bad I'll never grab it all to me more. But you do it and you fall and you come back again. But if today you can realize that from now I'm going to present everything that I'm doing to him, it shall be well with you. I don't know why. I don't know why that you are going through this. Because one thing that I know, that our God is there for us. The God that who protected you yesterday, the same God is here tonight to protect you as well. But without presenting your case to him, how can God do it? Without preparing yourself for him, every situation that you are going through, just a preparation. God is preparing you for another level. God is preparing you for him to take you to another ride. God is preparing you for him to take you to things that you need. Your heart desire that you are praying for. You are praying for so long that, oh God, let my heart desire come. That's why tonight I am here for you. You need your heart desire. But God said, I should tell you that it's preparing you before he will give you your heart desire. God prepared people before they can get to a destination. Your destination is far, but you need God's intervention. You need God's protection. You need God's light before you can get there. So that is what I am telling you, that God is preparing you before you can get to your destination. Your destination is most important, but without God preparing you, you cannot get there. Because in the middle of the road, there is a danger in the road. So that's why you need God to prepare you before he can take you across. You need the hand of God in your life. You need the hand of God in your life. But you don't want to open yourself for God to touch you. You wish that, oh, I wish I can preach. Yes, but when you prepare yourself, when you open your heart, God will come and sit in and use you. Because Bible said, 1 Corinthians coming down, he said, the body is the temple of God. So God can use his temple all the time. But you haven't present, you haven't prepared yourself for him or her. Prepare yourself for him. Prepare yourself for God so that God can use you. Your business that has collapsed, you did not present your business to him, God. But when you present your business to God, God will make sure that he's going to protect you so that the business will rise up again. The disappointment and delays in your life, present to him, God, and God is going to open a door for you. I don't know why that you are crying. I don't know whatever you are going through that you think that God cannot make it. I am here to assure you that God will make a way where there is no way. Not you alone. God have done it for several people. The time has come that God needs to touch you or prepare you before you get to your destination. Your destination is most important to God. Your destination is most important to Him. So always we make sure that you go to prepare you before you get to your destination. So everything, situation that you are in, everything that you are going through, just prepare yourself. Preparation, God is preparing you to before He takes you to the next level. I don't know whatever you are going through, sister. What is in your mind right now? What kind of plan do you have that you have? You have that you present to Him, God. The whole year from January up to now, you don't have no plan that you are going to present to God. You don't have it. So how can God protect you? How can God do your heart desire without present to Him? I am here to tell you tonight that everything that you are going through, just present to Him, God. And woman, when you present to Him, God will make a way where there is no way. I'm talking to you, madam. Madam, that you are listening to me, I am talking to you. Whatever you are going through, just present it to God. Go to your knees and present to God. Your situation will change. Because God is prepared to change that situation. God is prepared to open another door. God is prepared to lift you up. But without preparing you, God will never open that doors for you. So everything that you are going through, says to yourself that it's just a training. You are preparing yourself for another realms. God will never bless you without taking you through temptation. God will never bless you. Why God will not prepare you before you get the blessing? Because it will make you strong. It will make sure that you are so strong so that when you receive that blessing, nobody can take it from you. You know that you don't know how to pray. You know that you don't go to church. You know that even at all you don't go to prayer, like you don't have nothing to do. Even at all you don't believe Him. So how can that God bless you? How can God open the door for you? Because if God opened the door for you, somebody can take it from you one day. So God will never open until God prepares you for you to become strong before He can open that door for you. That is how Christians will not understand. That's why always we are crying, we are believing, we are shouting that, oh, I don't know that God is there for me. If God is there, I don't think that I'll go through. No, you are still going through because God is preparing you. No matter how. Sister, brother, that you are listening to me tonight. If you want God to do something for you, open your heart, open yourself for God to sit in and do it. Without preparing your heart, you cannot receive. Without presenting your case to God, God will never have. Because it's a God at the moment when you present your case, that God is going to do it. Every situation that you are going through, without presenting to God, God will never do it. That's why I say, oh man of God, oh, my prayer request has been taking so long. Yes, because you haven't prepared your heart. You haven't prepared yourself for Him. Physically, everybody knows that you are going to church. But spiritually, you don't have no faith in God. And listen to the occurs, sorry. Faith is something that you cannot see, but will believe. Moment when you believe, it surely come to pass. So without believing Him, without trusting God, without knowing that God can make a way for you, there is nothing that God can do. Because it's a God that always, when you ask, that God is going to do it. Bible said, He says, seek me, Matthew, He says, seek me. Seek me and find me. When you find me, I'll do your heart desire. What are you going through tonight? What are you going through that you don't want to rejoice in the Lord? Whatever you are going through that you cannot be happy in for your life. Whatever you are doing that the enemy has taken actually control so that you don't have no choice. You don't have nothing. You don't even up to today, you don't have nothing. What are you going through, sister? Every time has a time. Every season has a time. God time is the best. God time is the best. God know the time that he, God, is going to bless you. God know the time that he's going to protect you. God know the time that he's going to open that door for you. So when the time hasn't come yet, there is nothing that God is going to release it to your hands. I am here tonight to ask you tonight, what are you going through? What did you see yourself? Are you rejoicing the Lord? If I rejoice in the Lord, Bible said in Philippians chapter 4, verse 6, coming up, it said, do not be exulting about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, present your request to God. Present your request to him. Present whatever you are going through to him. And the peace of God, which transcends all understand, will guide you, your heart and your mind. When you present your case to him, God is going to guide you. God is going to guide you. God is going to protect you. God is going to make sure that wherever you put your feet will never hurt. But you don't want to present to him. That's why your situation is still there. That's why your sickness is still there. That's up to now. You are crying that you need a baby up to now. Because you haven't presented to him, God. You need the hand of God to touch you. You need God to come into your life. But without preparing yourself or without opening your heart, God will never come and stay in your house. Unless you prepare your house, unless you clean your house, unless you take every dirty thing from your house, then God will come into your house to stay. But you, rather than to watch him life, you haven't think that way. We have not even think about that. You don't think that maybe God can make it. You don't think that God can even open that door for you. That is your mind and that is your knowledge. That's what you think. But God has a different thinking for you. God is going to open a door where there is no door. And God is going to take you to your destination. Everything that you are going, it doesn't matter, but the situation that when God will make sure that will set you free. Everything that is in your leg, God will take actually control. Everything that is in, you are crippled. Now you cannot walk, you cannot do anything. My God is there to set you free. My God is here to set you free. So, brother, sister, that tonight you are here with me. Bible says, rejoice in the Lord always. Rejoice in the Lord. Don't think about the coronavirus. Don't think about everything that you cannot do. Don't think about it. But present everything that you need to him. But when you present to him, God, that God will make a way where there is no way. You need a hand of God. You need a hand to touch you. But you don't want to prepare your heart so that God can touch you. God is a spirit. Without preparing yourself, God cannot help you. Sometimes you think that your knowledge alone can do it. Sometimes you think that your knowledge can do it. But in the middle of the road, before you see, your knowledge cannot work again. What are you going through? What is your problem tonight? Why are you crying all the time? You need the hand of God. You need God in your life. You need God to touch you. You need God to deliver you. The God that you are, He's there for us. That God will make a way where there is no way. I don't know whatever you are crying, and I don't know whatever you are going through. Maybe yours is a marriage problem. Now, right now that you are listening to me or you are hearing my voice, you wish that, I need to come out from this marriage. But you don't know that when you present your problem to God, God can fix that marriage for you. There is a hole. Both of you has opened yourself for the devil to come in to destroy this marriage. But when you present it to God, God will make a peace into that marriage. I don't know. But tonight, I am here to tell you tonight. I am here to tell you that rejoice in the Lord all the time. Rejoice, no matter how, whatever you go through. Just be happy and rejoice in the Lord and thank Him. No matter how, whether you have it, you don't have it. When you wake up in the morning, say, God, I thank you for my life and my family. How many times have you wake up in the morning and pray? How many times did you think that God can make it a way? How many times that do you think that God will make a way for you? How many times that do you think that God can take you in and brought you home safe? You think that maybe you cannot. That's why that's your thinking. That is what you think. But I am here tonight to tell you that, sister, brother, that you are listening to me tonight. Our God is a God that always protecting us. It's a God that always guiding us. It's a God that always do for us. So be happy. Rejoice in the Lord all the time. No matter how. No matter how, whatever situation that you are in today, right now that I'm talking about. Go to your knees and say, God, I thank you. No matter how, whatever I go through, I give you thanks. Let your will be done. Let your will be done. Let your will be done, because God knows you more than yourself. God knows you more than yourself. God knows you more than yourself. So why are you crying? Why you cannot present your case to Him? Why you cannot see that that God is here to help me? Why you are not preparing yourself that so that God will come and sit down in your house to clear every dirty thing that is going on into your house? But you refuse to invite Him. I am here tonight to let you know that invite God into your life. I am here to tell you that just embrace the word of God. A moment when you embrace the word of God, that means God will come into your life. Don't think about whatever you are going through. Don't think about something that you have done for somebody and that person could not thank you. Don't think about the goodness that you have made and people are paying you bad. Don't think about it. But think that God is there to make a way where there is no way. Think that you are not the only person that God can help. The time has come that you, God, need to help you. The time has come that God need to do everything for your life. So tonight, you need the hand of God. Wherever you are listening to my voice and you are watching me live from Facebook, YouTube, other multimedia system, you need a hand of God. You need some strong hand to touch you. You need God to open that door for you. You don't have no hope in your life, but God has hope for you. God knows that you can make it. God knows that you're going to get you a child. God knows that you come out from that problem that you are going through now. God knows that that sickness cannot kill you. God knows that enemy will never, never frustrate your life, all right, but they cannot kill me. God knows. So why you are not embracing that call? Why not say, God, I thank you for everything that you have done for me and my children? Not everybody have seen this light tonight. Not everybody can speak like me and you. When you go to hospital right now, you see how many people reported sick today. And you see how many people pass away, die today alone. You are not better than them. You are not better than them. But by the grace of God, that's what today you are alive and I'm alive. So why you are not allow ourselves? Let us all come together and thank him for whatever God has done. God is always thinking good about us. Because Bible said in Jeremiah 29:11, he said, I have I know the plan that I have for you, not a plan that I'll harm you, but a plan that is hope for future. That God has a hope and future for us. So why you don't go to him? Why you don't cry before him? Why you don't say, God, I am tired. Come and take actual control now. Or why you don't invite? I say, God, right now I cannot do it again. I need your help. Come and take actual control in my situation. And see if your situation cannot change. Tonight I am here to tell you. Maybe you lost your job. And you are now thinking about how can you get a job. But you are forgetting that it's God who opened that door for us. It's God who shared that job. So far as you were servant, so far as you are a child or daughter, that God is going to give you your heart desire. The sickness that you are going through, or your brother or your sister is going through, you think that maybe that sickness will kill your teacher, or it kill your sister or your brother or whoever, your nephew or whatever it is. So you are forgetting that you present that case to God. But when you present that case to him, God will make a way where there is no way. God is going to protect them and make sure that their life will never be the same. You need a life that God has touched. You need a life that God has touched. When God touches your life becomes different. Always praying to God that God, all what I need is let your anointing come upon my life. Because the Bible said anointing break yokes. Everywhere that they are not accepting people, you alone, because of the anointing, they will accept you. Every situation that you go through, moment when you speak, because of the anointing, people will hear and people will accept. You need the anointing of God. When you open yourself, God will come in and sit with you. Without opening yourself, God will never come and sit with you. God needs you. God knows whatever you are going through. And God is here tonight to open that door for you. I am here to bring you this word. I am here to bring you this message. Rejoice in the Lord all the time. Rejoice in the Lord all the time. Rejoice on him. No matter how the circumstances that you go through, no matter how whatever you go through, the only thing that you just rejoice in the Lord and say, God, I thank you for my life and I thank you for my children. Moreover, that you are saying that God knows your problem already. God knows your problem. So sometimes, without present to him God, God will never do it. But when you present to him, already God knows your problem. And all the only thing that God need from you is just know him that is God and believe him that he is the only one that he can take care of you. That's what God needs. God don't need your money. God don't need your job. God don't need anything from you. But the only thing that God needs is just accept the word and move forward. Just embrace the word and just move forward. When you do that, your destination will be shorter. When you do that, you can get to your destination. Because we are all working through our destinations. Upon struggle that you are struggling upon, everything that we do, we are all praying that when we die, we can go to heaven. Heaven is our destination. So I am asking you tonight that whatever you are going through, are you thinking about your destination or you are thinking about material things? Or do you think that you are going to live into this world forever? No. The time has come that you can never even speak again. The time will come that even you cannot do anything. That time, your time has come. So everything that you are doing, just do it quick so that you can wash your hand from it until you get to your destination. Because God can call you anytime. But that's why Matthew 22:40 said, many I call, few people that I chose them. So ask yourself, ask God that, God, I also am a chosen one. If you are not, then you know what to do. If you are not, then you need to advise yourself. If you are not, then you need to think about it. How can you change your life so that you can get to your destination? If so, your destination is most important to God. Your destination is most important to everyone that you are listening to me. It's a mighty God. It's a God that he can do it abundantly. It's a God that always do it for us. It's a God that always taking us out and brought you home safe. Wherever you are watching me live from Facebook, YouTube, or the multimedia system, after this message, you are going to sleep. So who is going to guide you for you to sleep and let you wake up in the morning? It's God. So why you don't want to believe on that man? Why you don't want to put your hope and your trust on that man? Because he's the only one that he can do it for you. Don't put your hope on human beings. Human being cannot do anything for you. Human being will go to disappoint you the time that you need that person help. The time that you need that person help, that is the time that that person is going to say, I am sorry, I cannot. Already you put your hope on him or her. So when it comes that he says he don't have any help for you, what are you going to do? But tonight, don't put your hope on any human being. Don't believe. Don't trust any human being. The only thing that presents your case and yourself to him, God. And when we do that, that God is going to do it. I thank you that tonight you are here with me. I thank you that you are watching me live from Facebook, YouTube, other multimedia system that you are watching me live. You are welcome to the program. The title of the message is Rejoice in the Lord. Philippians chapter 4, verse 4 to 7. Sometimes, Christians think that whatever they are going through, they cannot come out. But God is there. Our God is our Savior. Our God is a judge. Our God is a lawyer. Our God is a doctor and a nurse. That God is going to do everything for you. That God is going to heal you. That God is going to touch you. That God is going to help you for you to establish your business again. So what are you going through? What are you going through? I know that the God that we are serving, that God, is going to make a way where there is no way. The God that we are serving, that God is here tonight. And that God is going to do it for you. Fear not. Fear not. Fear is a devil and fear is Satan. Fear is demonic. When fear comes upon your life, you cannot do anything. So take fear out of your life and rejoice in the Lord. Whatever situation that you see yourself in, just rejoice in the Lord. Take fear out of your life. Because Bible said in Psalm 23 verse 4, it said, even though I walk through the shadow of the valley of shadow of death, I will not afraid. For you with me and the rope of myself, they comfort me. Even though I walk through the valley of shadow of death, I will not be afraid of evil. For you are with me. Your robe and your scarf, they comfort me. The God is there for us. Do not scare. Don't let any fear touch you. Because Bible said in Psalm 27 verse 1, said, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is my stronghold of my life. Whom shall I be afraid? You are scared. Fear is attaching you, so you cannot make it. Instead of you to every circumstance and rejoice, just be happy for God. But you are scared. Oh, how can I be happy? Oh, this problem. Hey, I know that this problem is a big problem. Oh, hey, this problem is so, so, and so. But he has forgotten that God is bigger than that problem that he's talking about. Tonight, I am here to present this message to you. Tonight, I am here to release this message for you. And then you may. Me wa hasa me disa asemu we be ma wo ma woni nyi awawrade mu na yi ehu efiri wa bra boso. Take fear out of your life and let us see if God will never help you. Rejoice in the Lord always and see if God will bless your life, because your life is in the hands of him. God hold your life. And God said, do not afraid. 365 days or leap year is 366 leap year. When you check in, when you do your research in the Bible, each day, God said, do not afraid. That means God is there for us. So everything that we see ourselves with, don't afraid. Because God is there for us. And God can protect us. Because when we read Psalm 118 verse 6. Say, the Lord is with me. I will not be afraid. What can a man do to me? What can a man do to you? A man will never do anything to you. Just promise and fail. So don't put your hope on that man. Don't put your trust on that person. Because that person cannot help you. The only person that can help you is God. That's why he said that rejoice in him all the time. No matter how the situation that you are going through, rejoice yourself within him. I thank you that tonight you are here with me. I thank you that you are watching me live from Facebook and YouTube, all the multimedia system. God bless you. Make sure that you share the page. Make sure that you share the page. Call someone. He said, Reverend is here to give a word of God. The title of the message is Rejoice in the Lord. Philippians chapter 4, verse 4 to 7. Because of fear has crippled you. Because of fear, you cannot do anything. But tonight, if you will listen to the word of God and you take fear out of your life, that door will be open. If you take fear out of your life, your belly, you can give child. If you take fear out of your life, your business will rise up again. Because God is there to make it. Make sure that everything that you are doing, you do for God. Make sure that everything that you do for Him. When you do for Him, that God will make a way. What are you going through? That God is here tonight. That God is here to make. That God is here tonight to make a way where there is no way. Whatever you are going through, that God is here. I don't know whatever you are going through tonight. The God that you serve, that God is here. I thank you that you are here tonight with me. And I thank you that you are listening to the word of God. The title of the message is Rejoice in the Lord with all your heart and with all your mind. Put your trust on Him. Believe on Him. He's the only one He can do. Wherever you are listening to me. I thank you that you are here with me. I thank you that you are listening to the word of God. God bless you. God bless you that you are here with me. God bless you that everything that you have heard today, it shall be well with you. That God is here tonight.
Amen.
Everything that you are going through. Let us all be happy and rejoice in the Lord all the time. This is your Reverend Ebenezer Sacharias Protocol. I am here to just entertain you, to give you that word of God. I know that the word of God has come and you accepted it. The moment you accepted the word of God, that word of God is going to change your character. Maybe there is a sickness that you are going through. While you are receiving the word of God, that sickness will flow. Hey! Hey! I'm not going to be able to do that. And then you may be out to be a Makaba do by my dear. Meaning you much is you with that. Ah, 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 I thank everybody that were here with me tonight. I thank you that were listening to the word of God. Hey! Ah! Yeah! Yeah! Ah! 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 Hey! Ah! Send me a new Matthew. Dara de Vemba. Ah, Mama, we found out you enjoy what the young girl. The great family of Usia in our side. Mima will be our Jimmy Bio, I remember our great family of Usia. Sunday, we have been on song, Papa, Omo Baba, Baba, your meeting, Cassia, our human so. Na Ubiara, oh, yeah, I remember Biano, on fan to one, on fan to us, Sunday, we and on Baba, your meeting, to Bomadia, say, O Baba, be so Pecosua, Jenia, Bomadia, so Befre, Senoma, we, Cecilia, Boating, the nominee, 5 7 1 4 9 0 1 2 3 0 5 7 1 4 9 0 1 2 3 0 Me from Nabo Madianso Babe Jalikono, a Radin Chamina. Hey, Yanka! Ah! Yay! And Kanon and Amazon, my baby. Ah! Yes, I don't mention that. I was saying, I just say, Nama, and the coronavirus, Sabina, and Kusukwe, yeah? I hope you are 2 years ago, so quite here. Yeah, oh, Baba Christian, I was saying, yeah, young boy. Ah, 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 yeah, yeah, ah, 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 senior, my job for the CM, I'm going to come back to my days. Bishop Perry, look, Perry, baby, I will be having my grandma. Hey, yeah, ah, ah, hey, Prophet Obed, I know that you are watching me live from Koforidia. Oh, the people that are watching me live from Koforidua, Kukurentumi Hospital, Naomi Nyako and Sidi Nyako, Naomi Nyako, also for mommy, baby, I'm in the social, Mrs. Ya, Yamin Shra, anyway, baba. Hey, ah, ah, very soon God is going to bless who we are. The devil that is planning evil concerning your life, don't you see you that you are blessed? So I am here to tell each and everyone that don't worry about it. After this coronavirus, God is going to open a door. The doors has been open for each and everyone that will listen to my voice. Hey! Yeah! 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 I thank everybody that were here with me. Thank you so much that were here. Before we go, I'll go to the prayer line to ask secretary. Secretary has something for us. Secretary, I know that. Secretary, are you here with me? Do you have any message for us?
Yes, I'm here, Prophet.
Yes. Okay, let's go.
I'm here.
Send your message so that we can go, please.
Oh, I just want to, a quick reminder, just remind those who committed to supporting the radio ministry, that they shouldn't forget them. I just want to encourage them to stay true to their commitment. So that's all I have.
Thank you, Secretary. Brother Victor, are you here with us? Brother Victor, do you have anything for us? Brother, are you here with us? Okay, brother is not here. Ed Adakun, are you here? Okay. Ed Adakun is not here. Okay, if you are not here, I am not going to mention your name. People that they are here, if I see that, if I mention your name 2-3 times and you are not respond, I am not going to mention your name again. Because otherwise, the whole world is listening to us. And every day we are mentioning your name. Sometimes we say, oh, why? This man of God don't know what he's doing. We know what you are going. If you are not coming here, let me know so that I will not come in and stay here and mention your name. I thank everybody that are watching me live and everything. Before we share the grace, anybody have anything so that we can share before we share the grace? If somebody has something. Secretary has already said everything for us. People that they committed themselves to support the radio station. I know that they are going to do it. God bless you that you are going to do it. Send, if you haven't sent your prayer request, please send your prayer request for me, please. If you haven't sent it. Okay. If nobody have anything to say, let us we all share the grace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us and forevermore. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen and amen. I love each and everyone that's watching me live from Facebook and YouTube, all the multimedia system. I thank you that you are here with me. I love you. I will see you on Thursday, prophetic ministry. Thursday is going to be a prophetic ministry. Make sure that you join us into our prayer life. It's going to be fantastic. It's going to be who is not in the dictionary. So when you go to the dictionary, you cannot find who, but it's going to be something great. I am giving you the number. When you check on our Facebook, you see the church number there. You see the prayer line number. The number is 712-770-4160. 712-770-4160. The access code is 753257. 753257. Make sure that Thursday is a prophetic moment, 9:30, then we'll start. One man of God is going to join me, and it's going to be so from 9, it's going to be prophetic all round, prophetic all round. I thank you that you are here. God bless you, and I love you all. Bye bye. Love you all. Bye.
Goodbye. Father, we bless you, Lord. Whether we have it or not, we will worship you. Daddy, we give you praise. We worship you. Somebody say, Daddy, the song you are singing, I don't understand. You don't need to understand the song I'm singing. You also have a song to sing. Sing unto your Lord. Sing unto your Lord. Lima Sakataya. Let's all sing this song. We praise thy name, oh Lord. We praise thy name, oh Lord. We praise thy name, oh Lord. We praise. Magnify.